Arakku, a petite tribal village nestled in the luscious green valley of the hilly terrain, is a sight to behold. About 19 tribes inhabit the dense forest. Sumaskans launched its project, the first of its kind, to work amidst the tribal boys. Earlier, we had no facilities at all, and it was a struggle to go to school. Now, we are provided with the best facilities one can avail in a home. We have comfortable bunker beds, fine dining room, toilets, play area, and ground for outdoor sports too. Miani Nilayam is a home for tribal boys. 130 boys stay here in the new premises that offer better facilities and the best of education. The boys are encouraged to play sports, read books, and undertake other extracurricular activities, which develops their overall personality. Every year, a cricket tournament is conducted for the youth from Arakku Valley. Our son goes to school. It is a great opportunity for children to study here. They are cared for and provided best facilities. All this helps to make the tribal boys more self-reliant, responsible, and articulate. It helps to nurture a sense of self-worth in each child. The boys go to school where the medium of instruction is both English and Telugu. After the Sumaskans came, things have changed for the better. We are very contented and satisfied. The major seminary in Chennai, Jerome Illam, runs a home called Udayavasal for battered boys who are afflicted with pain, tortured, and deprived of love. At present, 18 boys, orphans, semi-orphans, and abandoned children are cared for by the community. The children grow in a healthy environment and are being sent to good schools for education. I have only a sister. My father and mother died of AIDS. We were then taken care of by our grandmother. She is old and unable to take care of us. A Sumaskan father approached us and we shared our stories with him. Then he brought me to this home. I am very happy here as I now belong to a family. The children here grew up learning to share and live amicably with the other inmates. They grew as one family. The bonding is so strong that each child looks at the other as his own sibling. Spiritual values and values of life are instilled in them so that they can weather the storms in life and battle it out to face the future. Many of these boys have bitter stories untold. There are 11 seminarians doing their theological studies as part of the formation. The community plays a vital role in molding these children and helping them to heal the wounds and scars of rejection and neglect of their past. Miani Illam at Nagarkoil runs a home for tsunami victims and is also involved in social outreach programs like tuitions, medical aid and counseling. My family was shattered after the tsunami. The fathers helped me to go through my studies. The community has now started St. Jerome College for Career Education for the youth. The college is waiting for the sanction from the government and hopes to throw open admissions in the coming academic year. In this home, seminarians do their academic studies as part of their formation.
Christ is in me, Christ is in you, Christ is in us all. Christ is in the hearts of all the peoples of the world. This is surely the kingdom of God, yes, this is heaven indeed. That Christ he lives in all humanity.
The second being activities extended outside our home to more than 500 needy children. Scholarships are given to these children till they complete their academic courses.
I am in standard 5 and being helped by the fathers for my studies. The Somaskans provide scholarships irrespective of caste or creed to about 500 students, 400 in Bangalore and 100 in Chennai, till they complete their academic courses. We have only our mother. The Somaskans are educating us and there are many children like us.
Hi, my name is Jay Anthony Sadish. Now I'm the diploma in electronics.
Due to poor finance, I was unable to go for computer education. Now, with the scholarship provided by them, I have completed my studies.
We have also been building houses, thus providing a roof for the homeless.
Houses have been constructed for 4 families in Chennai. I am a widow left with 2 physically challenged children and had no house to call our own. The fathers built a house for us. We are extremely happy and feel safe. 22 houses have also been built in Kalkere for families that have been displaced. The site was given by the Karnataka government and the cost of construction was Rs 1.5 lakhs. Most of the contributions poured in from sponsors abroad. They were delighted to participate in the inaugural function. We went through very hard times. My husband met with an accident and had to undergo a surgery. It was then that I approached the fathers. They were a great support and strength to us. They also built us a home to live in. We are simply touched by their simplicity, and I pray to the Lord to bless them in all the good works they do. Tuitions are facilitated for children in Suryodaya and Premalaya.